3rd July, Saint Thomas, Apostle, Solemnity. Thomas is renowned among the apostles chiefly because of his lack of faith, which was dispelled when the risen Christ appeared to him. He proclaimed what is in fact the Easter faith of the church when he said, "My Lord and my God." Nothing certain is known of his life apart from what is given in the Gospels, but tradition has it that he preached to the people of India. From the 6th century, a feast of the translation of his relics has been kept at Edessa on 3rd July. A reading from the homilies of Pope Saint Gregory the Great on the Gospels. My Lord and my God. Thomas, called the Twin, who was one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. He was the only disciple missing. When he returned, he heard what had happened, but he refused to believe what he heard. The Lord came once more and offered his side to his skeptical disciple to be touched. And he showed his hands and the scars of his wounds, and he healed the wound of Thomas' disbelief. What conclusion, dear brethren, do you come to? Surely it was not by chance that this chosen disciple was missing in the first place, or that on his return he heard, that hearing he doubted, that doubting he touched, and touching he believed. It was by divine dispensation and not by chance that things so fell out. God's mercy worked wonderfully, for when that doubting disciple touched his master's wounded flesh, he cured the wound of our disbelief. His skepticism was more advantageous to us than the faith of the disciples who believed. Inasmuch as he came to believe by actually touching, we can lay aside all doubt, for our faith is made whole. So this doubting disciple who actually touched became a witness to the reality of the resurrection. Thomas touched him and cried out, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Because you have seen me, Thomas, you have believed." The Apostle Paul said, "Only faith can guarantee the blessings that we hope for, or prove the existence of the realities that remain at present unseen." It is abundantly clear that faith provides the proof for those things that cannot be seen. Visible things do not require faith. They command recognition. Inasmuch as Thomas saw and touched, why was it said to him, "Because you have seen me, you have believed"? What he saw was one thing, what he believed another. A mortal man could not have seen God. Thomas saw a man, but by his words, "My Lord and my God," he acknowledged his divinity. It was by seeing that he believed, for he recognized the reality of the man and cried out that he was God, although he could not see God. What follows is a source of great joy. Blessed are they who have not seen and have believed. This expression makes a special reference to us, for we have not seen him in the flesh, but know him in the mind. So, if we put our faith to the proof by good works, we are blessed. He who gives expression to his faith is a genuine believer. Saint Paul says of those whose faith is merely nominal. They profess their faith in God, but their actions give them the lie. For this reason, James says, "Faith without works is dead."